blockchain, a growing and future technology. This is what we are going to discuss about today in this session. So in this video, I shall be giving you an overview of the technology called blockchain. Welcome to Intellipaat, guys. So without wasting much of the time, let us quickly go through the agenda of today's video. So we shall first be learning about what is blockchain. To understand it better, we would be looking at some of the important features of blockchain, followed by the built-in features that make blockchain a safe and secure technology. And then we shall understand how actually blockchain works, what is the internal mechanism of blockchain. We shall also be seeing its use case to understand its implementation in real life. And finally, what career growth it has got to offer you. So let's get started. So what is blockchain? Blockchain, as name suggests, it is nothing but a linear chain of blocks. It is a digital ledger that holds information of transactions taking place over the web. So every block here contains data in the form of coding that is organized in chronological manner. So this is the simplest definition to understand what is blockchain. Let us now go through various features of blockchain that make this technology a strong contender for the top technologies in the near future. So this technique was originally described by a group of researchers in 2008 and was originally intended to timestamp digital document to ensure no one could tamper the data that had once passed through the server. So blockchain actually uses a decentralized structure to process the transactions. It created a peer-to-peer or a distributed environment with immutability. And all this led to the most important advantages of using this technology, and that is security. So it gives this security to your transactions. Now let's go through each of these in detail. Decentralized network. So what does it mean and what all advantages it brings along? So this technique is built on decentralized structure. That means it eliminates the need of a single or centralized system that would be in charge of all the transactions taking place across the network. Since there is no centralized system, there is no single authority. It has got a distributed authority, and hence not a single entity or a person is in charge of everything. Due to this, your transactions get faster since it is a direct communication. And all this would eventually lower down your cost. You don't really need to pay the fee amount that an intermediary would charge you for lending you their services and giving you a platform. I hope it's clear to you guys, right? So let's move ahead. Now let us move on to the second feature, which is distributed network. Now, blockchain works on distributed network. That is to say, every node in the network has got access of every block of information, resulting in bringing in transparency. Now, since it is public and everyone has got the hold of entire network, hence it becomes nearly impossible to tamper with the data logged in a block. And if anyone tries to make some false changes into the already existing blocks, all the nodes would get notified of the same and the attempt of tampering would fall futile. So it verifies the attempt of changes in no time. This seems quite interesting, right? But how does it happen? So we'll see in the coming slides to come. Now, immutability and security. Let's discuss these. Now, blockchain is a technology that supports immutability. What does that mean? So it means once a code has been logged into a blockchain and passed through the server, it cannot be changed. And similarly, since the code cannot be tampered with, results are also the same and cannot be tricked. And hence, it brings you a sense of security, exactly. For example, if some organizations has made a promise to you and if it is logged into a blockchain, then the organization could never step back and has to live up to its promises. I know, this must be sounding just like a must-have feature to you in today's dual-phase environment, isn't it? So we saw one of the main reasons as to why transactions done through blockchain is secured. Now let us go a little deeper into it to understand it better. But before doing so, let us know what all a blockchain consists of. So a block has got, number one, a hash. I'm going to describe it in a while. And then the data, and finally the hash of the previous block. Now hash is nothing but a fingerprint of a block. And any changes in the block would lead to changing the hash of the block. And hence making hash of all the following blocks invalid, since each block consists hash of the previous block. So hash does play a crucial role in the security, but again, in today's technologically driven world, creating a hash is not a big deal. And hence, just having a hash cannot stop a miscreant to tamper with your data. And that is why we have got another crucial concept in blockchain, and that is called proof of work. So this makes blockchain data almost impossible to alter. So this is nothing but the first consensus algorithm. Proof of work increases the time required to create a new hash, and hence making the technology secured one. So before anyone can change the hash of entire network, nodes are notified of the tampering attempt, and hence tampering becomes a tough task to perform, almost impossible. So now I hope that you guys must have got a fair idea about how this technology is so secure. Right, now let's move forward and see its applications. Bitcoin. This is the famous application of blockchain. So blockchain was originally conceptualized by Satoshi Nakamoto when he published the white paper Bitcoin, a peer-to-peer electronic cash system. So the first Bitcoins were mined in 2009, and thus was born the exciting technology of blockchain. So this is a cryptocurrency, that means digital cash. And digital currency which runs on blockchain method and has got limited supply. Now let's check out how do we actually implement blockchain in real life applications. Ethereum. It is again a blockchain which is designed specifically for smart contracts. So it is a sort of cryptocurrency and allows to transfer values in form of ether, and also allows you to create smart contracts or code to be deployed to blockchain. So what is a smart contract? Smart contract is nothing but a digital contract that cannot be amended. Yes. You can also get detailed information about smart contract and Ethereum in our previous videos, link of which have been mentioned in the description below. And finally, we have got Solidity. So Solidity is a contract-oriented high-level language. So the syntax of Solidity is similar to JavaScript. So basically, you write your smart contract using Solidity language and then execute it on Ethereum virtual machine and do your blockchain transactions. Now I guess that you must have got a fair idea of what is blockchain and advantages of using this. Now let me take an example of a real life scenario to differentiate between a normal transaction and a transaction through blockchain. So let's suppose if you want to take some loan from a bank, what would you do then? So you definitely would go to a bank executive and ask for the EMIs the loan would incur you every month, interest rate, principal amount deduction, etc. And after going through all the formalities, you haven't sanctioned your loan amount, right? But what if after a few months bank increases the interest rate? What would you do then? So you have to anyhow fall in line with whatever the bank dictates, right? But if you had got this logged into a blockchain, the bank had to work according to the code specified into the blockchain for the entire tenure, which would mean no changes in the contract that you made with the bank while taking the loan. Relaxing, right? Now let us see how technically it works. So if you want to make a new transaction to an already existing blockchain, that is to say, you want to add a new block of data to the chain. So that block would actually get distributed to each of the nodes in the respective network. And then now every node would validate the authenticity of the block needed to be added to the chain. And once it is validated from all the nodes, then only the block would get added to the chain, just like this. So if any nodes finds any problem with the block would get rejected. So it basically works on consensus. So after knowing its technical aspect, now let's take a use case of such a working mechanism. DAO, exactly. So it stands for Decentralized Autonomous Organization, which is a decentralized and democratic organization. So it actually eliminates manual intervention to the lowest level. And all the managerial tasks is replaced by a set of terms and conditions or values that are agreed by all the parties involved in the transaction. And then every term and condition are decided through voting. And the final documentation is then logged into a code which would be passed through the server to perform all the future transactions. So let's say if any e-commerce company gets DAO implemented in the organization, they can have the following advantages. Number one, all the processes would be codified and hence no scope of making any manual error. Chances of having any discrepancies won't be there since it works on a collaborative consensus, right? And then overseeing of things would be eliminated. No need to have a specified hierarchy of position or authority. Actions like stock maintaining, delivery of the product, etc. are taken on automatic triggers and hence making the process faster and more efficient with lower cost. So blockchain's future certainly looks quite bright, isn't it? Now let's see how bright can it make your future. So let me tell you guys that blockchain expertise actually captured the number one position on the latest skills index by Upwork for being the hottest in the US job market. So this is just one of the many indicators of how high the demand is for people with blockchain skills. And hence, employment is never an issue for a blockchain professional. And a blockchain expert can garner around 86,000 per year. Sounds quite promising, right? So now let us do a quick recap on what have we learned in today's session. So we started off by understanding what exactly is blockchain. Then saw its different features, what makes it so secure, its applications and implementation. We also went through the working mechanism of blockchain and also saw how it can be implemented in real life situations. And ultimately talked about the career opportunities it has got for you. So if you feel excited about the course after watching this video, so learn blockchain course in detail, and you can do so with one of the best e-learning platforms, that is Intellipaat, exactly. So you can get a 360 degree knowledge about the course designed by the best of the industry experts. And with this, we come to the end of our video. Thank you so much for watching the video and giving us your precious time. For any inquiry, feel free to contact us anytime.
I hope the video was informative for you. Please like the video, and if you have any doubt, comment below. We shall respond to it at the earliest. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos. Do look out for other related videos in our playlist. For more detailed information, visit our website now. Have a great day and career ahead.